also some other leaders of different departments concerning and relating with the relation between Italy today. And may I invite you to take the floor, Excellency. Thank you very much.
Dear Vice Minister, first of all, thank you for the condolences you have expressed. It has been, we've been really going through a terrible time the last couple, 3 days for the loss that we have had on Sunday. And so thank you again. It is a great pleasure for me and an honor to lead the Italian delegation in this virtual political consultation between our two countries. I was just about, as you may know, to visit your wonderful country on February 2020 and then and meet you in person. And then unfortunately the pandemic broke out. Nonetheless, in 2020, I had two video meetings with the Vice Minister of Industry and Trade, and I attended recently the Scientific and Technological Cooperation Conference in Hanoi, Vice Minister Bui De Tsui. We attach great importance to the relations with Vietnam, one of the most important countries in Southeast Asia and a key member of ASEAN. In 2020, Italy became a development partner of ASEAN, and we are investing a lot in this new format of cooperation because we really believe that the region is one of the most promising and active in terms of future growth, development, and innovation. We are willing to build stronger bridges with ASEAN and to contribute to the region's positive perspectives. With a bilateral trade of around 4 billion euros, Vietnam is our main trade partner in the region. With over 100 Italian companies active in your country, we are also among the main EU investors in Vietnam. We believe our long-lasting partnership can prove even more beneficial on many topics that we will jointly discuss today. Dear Mr. Zung, let me congratulate upon your reappointment as Vice Minister of Foreign Affairs following the election of new Vietnam's government by the National Assembly last April. I will be grateful if you could extend my sincere congratulations to the new President of the Republic, the new Prime Minister, and the new President of the National Assembly, as well as to the Secretary General of the Communist Party of Vietnam, confirmed by the 13th Congress. Today's political consultations are an opportunity to take stock and further boost our excellent long-lasting friendship. The signature of the Action Plan 21st-22nd with a look to 23rd will operationalize our strategic partnership, bringing it to unachieved levels and enhancing our collaboration in areas of common interest. Political and diplomatic cooperation, defense and security, trade and investment, development cooperation, energy, climate and environment, education, science and technology, culture and people-to-people links. Allow me now to introduce the other members of the delegation. The Principal Director for Asia Pacific, Ms. Gabriella Biondi, that you surely know already, Vice Admiral Dario Giacomin, Deputy Secretary General, Minister of Defense, Mr. Olivero Montanaro, Director at the Ministry of Ecological Transition, and Mr. Domenico Di Giorgio, Italian Medicine Agency. I would like to greet our Ambassador to Hanoi, Mr. Antonio Alessandro. We also have the pleasure to have with us the Ambassador of Vietnam to Rome, Ms. Nguyen Thi Binh Quy. Here is much work ahead of us, so let's begin with the first item. We will now talk about the COVID pandemic and the lesson learned from it. Vietnam, in this topic, has been one of the most effective countries in fighting the spread of the virus and has achieved excellent results that allowed to resume nearly all economic and social activities, We are glad that the current wave of cases is basically under control, and we hope that this could soon lead to a softening of the quarantine's duration and conditions. Although the pandemic situation in Italy and all of Europe remains challenging, the overall sanitary conditions are steadily improving. Up to now, Italy had to face over 4 million infected and 125,000 deaths. We are confident that through an intensive and widespread vaccination campaign, we will be able to contain the contagion and reduce the numbers of deaths and patients in severe conditions. And so today, we fully vaccinated more than 10 million people and started the vaccination process for over 21 million people. And we are a total population of 60 million. That's important to say in terms of percentage. Italy believes that the COVAX facility remains the best tool for the international community to provide equitable and universal access to safe and effective COVID-19 vaccines. 59 million doses have been already delivered to more than 120 countries worldwide. 31 million doses have been assigned to Vietnam. We are glad to know that your country has already received over 4 million doses. Italy contributed in 2020 with 85.5 million euros for that. As G20 president, last May 21st, Italy hosted the Global Health Summit together with the European Commission. The summit reaffirmed a stronger support in favor of low and middle income countries to build expertise and develop local manufacturing capacities. In this occasion, Prime Minister Draghi announced additional 300 million euro to COVAX facility and 15 million vaccine doses for low income countries. The summit also highlighted the importance of voluntary licensing and know-how transfer as the best tool for ensure the equitable distribution of vaccines. Cooperation with industry is key. We encourage voluntary licensing and technology transfer, but we also follow closely the ongoing debate on the waiver of international property rights for COVID-19 vaccine. And now on this point, I leave you the floor and I thank you for listening.
Thank you, Excellency and the Secretary. So first of all, allow me to express my sincere thanks for your kind words about our bilateral relations.